totally fine.
that's the spirit.
It's okay. Yeah. Tom isn't here yet. Or at least I have not seen him. He's hardly in the but he's talking the latest one day, so it should be okay. And I won't panic him or anyone else yet. So I guess people are going to be arriving all the way through the day, but we might as well kick off now. I believe we're live on Twitch. I believe the quality is all right, or at least passable. So I will kick off. Welcome very sincerely to PROCJAM and the PROCJAM Talk Day, which I don't have a separate name for, so they're quite confusing, and some people think they're the same thing, or the jam's like one day long, or the talks last for a week. The slogan for the jam is make something that makes something, and that's because the jam's about procedural generation, and obviously I hope some of you are going to make games, but I also hope some of you are going to make maybe tools. I hope some of you are going to make art stuff, or toys, or Twitter bots, or board games, or not games, or just something. I just hope that everyone's going to make something that makes something, obviously. And it really means a lot to me that you're all here, and that there's loads of people watching on Twitch as well, and that we're going to have all of these talks recorded, and it's going to be a brilliant archive, not only to motivate people for the jam, but also just generally as a resource for people in the future. And I know that we've got lots of students taking part in the jam, lots of researchers are interested, some small indie studios are entering, as well as individuals. We have a theme. I did mention it yesterday. It's super optional. I did it because some people were asking if the jam had a theme. The theme is procedural generation, so as long as you're doing that, you don't need to do this. But we do have a theme. It is infinity if you want to interpret it however you want. But there's a great bit in the Super Game Jam documentary where I think maybe it's Cactus talks about themes and says if they're getting in the way of you having fun or making a cool game, they're not worth it. And that definitely applies here. So just chuck this theme to one side if it's not fun for you, and make whatever you want. The format we're going to have is 30-minute talk slots with one or two exceptions. There's a Q&A and a slightly shorter talk slot later on today. I said to the speakers, make your talks as long or as short as you want. So some of them will have time for questions, hopefully. And if you're watching on Twitch, I will do my best to monitor Twitch chat, but your best bet is to ask through Twitter with the hashtag PROCJAM. But we'll do our best to monitor both of those during the Q&A sessions at the end of each talk. The other thing I want to note is, if you're watching on Twitch and the channel goes down for whatever reason, the last time I streamed an event, the channel just disappeared halfway through. We got banned on Twitch for about 4 hours. Don't panic. Let me know on Twitter, at MTRC or at PROCJAM, and we will set up an alternative stream on YouTube as soon as we can. It has happened before. I've been promised by Twitch that it won't happen this time, but I don't put much stock into that. There's a load of people to thank, and I've got a longer thanks thing at the end, but there's three, well, not people, one of them's a person. There's three groups I want to thank just before we go on. The first is Azalea, she's sitting here at the front. Basically, the only co-organiser I've had for this event, she's done an enormous amount of work, particularly in the last week, and a huge amount of support. I submitted my thesis last Friday, Azalea's been writing papers all month, and on top of that, we've been doing this jam, so huge thanks to Azalea. Goldsmiths are hosting us today. They don't really know that they're hosting us. I just booked a room. But I'm going to thank them anyway. whatever. Thanks, Goldsmiths, if you're watching this for some reason. They're also doing our catering later, but they're being paid a lot of money for that, so I'm not thanking them. And finally, Prosecco, which is the reason that we can afford the catering. It's not much catering, which is not a reflection on Prosecco. They were very generous to us. They are a group designed to promote computational creativity to students and to game developers, among many other people. I'm basically the representative here, I guess, today, because I'm the only person, I guess I'm the closest person to computational creativity here. So if you want to ask me anything about that in breaks, I probably will just collapse in a heap with tiredness, but maybe another day. But if you want to learn more, I'm very grateful to them for their support today. It's seriously, seriously important. And obviously, thank you. I didn't expect there to be such an amazing response to this. And I'm really excited that all of you are here and psyched about procedural generation and psyched about the talks we're going to have. And yeah, it's going to be great. So I believe that's all I wanted to say. Every time I go to an event, they always tell you where the fire exits are. So they're at the back, if you want to know where they are. But I'm not planning to set fire to anything, so we probably won't need them. If you're on Twitch, the fire exit is directly behind you. And I believe that's all we have to say. So with that, I am going to welcome our first speaker, Gillian Smith, and start the day.